Superstars of Wrestling is on the air. Welcome, everyone, to the Superstars of Wrestling. I'm Vince McMahon, along with Jesse the Body Ventura. With a look at the things, you look like the deer hunter.
Ha, I'm dressed for war. You know why? Because the war for the Intercontinental Championship is about to begin. The Intercontinental Tournament coming your way.
Tito Santana versus us.
In the first round.
This week on the Superstars of Wrestling, brother love's guest will be the immortal Hulk Hogan. Joining us as well, the Earthquake, along with the Hart Foundation, Dino Bravo, Tugboat, and then from there, the first round of the Intercontinental Tournament, one-on-one, right here this week, Tito Santana versus Akeem.
This is a victory.
Quite a few young ladies about ringside that have a crush on the Hitman.
On the Worcester Centrum, we are getting closer, ladies and gentlemen, to the date of Friday night, May 18th. The WWF card on its way to Worcester. The Bushwhackers and Rhythm and Blues are going to collide in what should be an explosive tag team action. And speaking of explosive, how about the one-on-one confrontation with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, battling the Macho King, Randy Savage. All of this and more on Friday night, May 18th. It's the WWF at the Centrum in Worcester.
Watley locking up for the Hitman. Referee asking for the clean break here. An action smash, I'm sure. Looking on. Oh, yeah. Bret Hart was ready for that one.
Well, you're not going to fool a veteran like Bret Hart. You know, if Watley's going to get that in, he better be a little more sneaky than a roundhouse right.
Wow, what a move by Bret Hart. Hart is so quick. So agile. And then the big power man gets tagged.
Yeah, Neidhart, he's so crazy.
He is nuts, isn't he? And it's with reckless abandon that Neidhart does his thing in the square circle. Back body drop.
Whoa, whoa. And did he catapult him through the air on that one?
Nice shoulder block.
And then the laugh.
I love the laugh. Yeah, I do too.
Not demented much, is it?
Well, it sounds a bit to me. Bradley wide open. The Hitman takes over. Bradley having his problems. Here now some comments from Action Smash.
Hart Foundation, you sir do talk a mean fight, but can you fight as mean as you can talk? We can.
Talk is cheap, everybody does it. It's time to shut up and put up. We're going to find out how tough you boys really are.
I want to see that. Oh, that's going to be a great matchup, McMahon. Question is, I'm sure I'll be broadcasting it. Will you?
What do you mean? You trying to tell me something?
Well, it depends if they want the A broadcast team or the B team.
Oh, you're not insinuating that there's something to do with Brett Musburger. By the way, whatever happened with... Wait a minute. We'll get back to that and throw with a clothesline.
Wham! And this one take it to the bank.
Yes, indeed, the three count. Foundation. Chalk up yet another victory. One closer step and their quest to once again become World Wrestling Federation Tag Team title holder.
Here you see Neidhart with a beautiful back body drop right there. A lot of power in that move. Comes across, big shoulder block. Neidhart going aerial and then the patented Hart setup move. Neidhart holds him. Bret Hart clotheslines him. And Neidhart removes the shade.
The lights might be a little too bright.
From the pages of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, here's Update. All right, they've had the introduction of Hulk Hogan Children's Vitamins. I'm just catching up here on a little reading. Great stuff. Hi again, everyone. Last week, we had the opportunity to interview the streetwise and tough Bad News Brown. The news initially was aghast by the fact that I would be aware that he was celebrating his birthday. The man from Harlem was adamant at pointing out that he's not afraid of anybody or anything. With that in mind, let's go to this footage.
You know something, Mean Gene? For the first time in your life, you told the truth. Because Bad News Brown don't need no manager stealing his money. Bad News Brown doesn't need a partner who's going to stab him in the back. And Bad News Brown fears nobody, and he hates beer belly sharecroppers. And that means these people here.
Celebrating your birthday this week. Yeah.
Who told you about my birthday? What the heck's going on? You've been following me around or what?
No. Bad news, I understand.
No. How do you know it's my birthday?
I said I have it on good authority. And with that in mind, Bad News, I'm here to present you a birthday present.
A birthday present?
Yeah.
I don't want no birthday present. What is that? I don't want no birthday present.
It's
I don't need no birthday present.
It's for you.
I don't want it. I don't want no birthday present. What birthday present? Who gave you that to give to me?
Well, it's not important, who gave it to me.
Come on,
wait a minute.
It's my birthday present, isn't it?
Well, you said you didn't want it.
Don't worry about what I said. If you want to do something, here, stand here and hold this thing while I open it.
What is that? Why is he... What's wrong with him?
Wait a minute.
He's scared to death.
Wait a minute.
Just a
bad
box.
Hey.
Oh, look at that. Oh, my goodness.
It's only a rubber snake.
A rubber snake? He's standing there for me to know it was a rubber snake.
It's only a rubber snake. That's all it is here. You
yeah, well, you know who's behind this, don't you, Monsoon?
Who gave you that snake? Hey, who gave
what,
you that?
Get your
who
hands off the
ultimate. I'm going to find out who did it. And I'm going to be sorry.
That's disgusting. Kick him.
I tell you this, before my lawyers deal with Mr. Brown, I have the feeling that Jake the Snake Roberts may have a thing or two to say to Bad News Brown.
A birthday should be a happy occasion, Bad News Brown. All I was trying to do was put a smile on your face. I mean, you carry a chip on that shoulder so large, brother. All I wanted to do was make you a little happy. Well, happy birthday anyway, Bad News. Hope you enjoyed it.
Well, Jesse, I guess you could take a little solace in the fact that you're not the only one who's definitely afraid of snakes, apparently. Bad News Brown has a tremendous fear of snakes. I didn't think he was afraid of anything.
Now, who says that I'm afraid of snakes?
Well, you inferred that.
I've never inferred that, McMahon.
You can bet from the look on the face of Bad News Brown, he has a problem with the fear of snakes.
Totally, you can tell that. You know, that's what Jake loves.
I know.
Jake loves to find someone afraid of snakes.
What?
And
he does.
Hits on.
He really does.
Absolutely. Now, you didn't tell me that Dino Bravo was going to wrestle a singing celebrity.
Uh-oh.
Mitch Ryder.
Mitch Ryder.
Devil with the blue dress on. Good golly, Miss Molly.
Wow.
This is the guy that did it?
No, this is a different Mitch Ryder. I haven't seen that maneuver. Headbutt in the pectoral area. A little bit lower of being a solar plexus. Wow, what a ride Mitch Ryder just got. Oh, Jimmy Hart. Drive you insane with that megaphone. Standing by, Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
You know, Dino Bravo, I'm going to tell you something right straight up. I don't even care about taking my scissors to read to cut your hair because I'm concentrating all my efforts into kicking your butt in the first round of this tournament and making my way to the final round to take the Intercontinental belt.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
I don't believe that for one minute.
Don't believe what?
That all he cares about throwing up a smoke screen. Gut wrench.
Nice maneuver on the part of Dino Bravo.
One, two, pick him up.
Mitch Ryder, you and I can just sit back and listen to Jimmy Hart. He's doing commentary in ringside.
That's true. Mitch Ryder could use the Detroit wheels right now.
And now this time, the three count. Dino Bravo to meet Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Championship, one of the matches lined up in the tournament.
Here you see Bravo off the ropes. Wham! Drives that elbow into Mitch Ryder. And there's the patented Bravo side suplex. Finishing move, 1, 2, 3.
Hello, everyone. I'm Sean Mooney, and this is it. Live World Wrestling Federation action taking place tonight at the Boston Garden beginning at 8 p.m., there is still time to be a part of it. Do not waste another moment. Hulk Hogan will be here. He battles the Earthquake in the main event, and coming up this hour, we will have some last-minute comments from the Hulkster. Also, the Mighty Hercules, he battles Haku, the Superfly, Jimmy Snuka. He meets up with the Barbarian one-on-one. It's Axe and Smash of Demolition, the tag team champions. They put the belts on the line against the challengers, the Hart Foundation, Bret the Hitman Hart, and Jim the Anvil Neidhart. And also, you will see a great matchup between Jake the Snake Roberts and Bad News Brown. Now, there's been some speculation as to whether or not Bad News fears snakes. Right now, the man from Harlem is standing by with more on this encounter.
So you think you some kind of funny man, huh, Jake the Snake Roberts? You think you some kind of clown? You and that small dwarf sidekick of yours, that 80-year-old punk, thought it was a big joke by messing up my birthday celebration by giving me that gift, huh? Well, if I wasn't scared of a snake, but I'm not. That's right, I'm not. You will never know, because when you climb into that ring, Jake the Snake Roberts, you're not going to have a chance to get to that bag, and you're not going to have a chance to apply that DDT. Because I tell you one thing, Jake the Snake Roberts, when I get my hands on you, I'm going to put my foot so far up your backside that when you open up your mouth, your breath is going to smell like shoe polish. And I got something for Damien, too.
Bad News Brown out to put to rest any rumor that he fears anything, and that includes snakes, here in the World Wrestling Federation. Demolition, they will defend the tag team belts against the Hart Foundation.
Well, congratulations, Demolition. You are the World Wrestling Federation tag team champions. And rightfully so. But, let's face it, Demolition, you've gone through all the rest of the tag teams, but you're looking at the number one contenders, the Hart Foundation. There's an old saying, may the best team win. Well, you're looking at the best team right here, right, Anvil?
Right, Hitman. Demolition,
we want our belts back.
Well, individually, they are lethal. Together, they're the awesome force known as the Hart Foundation. They challenge Demolition tonight at the Boston Garden for the Tag Team Championship.
Standing by now, Bobby the Brain Heenan with a very determined, ravishing Rick Rude.
Take a good look, Ultimate Warrior. This is the only man that has ever defeated you for a title. Buddy, your days are numbered.
Ultimate Warrior, when we meet again, I will be an unstoppable force, an immovable object. And if you should be lucky enough to get me in a pin position, you too will be hoisted off just as easily as the 405 pounds on the bench press. Ultimate Warrior, I can read you like a book. I have beaten you before, and I will beat you again. Once more, Ultimate Warrior, I will take the title that you hold so dearly.
Five more. How bad do you want it? One more. Ultimate Warrior can do two more. Can you do two more? Push it up. Come on. Come on. More. 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 One more.
All right, here we go, Jesse. The first round of the Intercontinental Tournament.
What a tremendous matchup this is going to be, McMahon.
And Rowdy Roddy Piper beating Rick Martel. It's pick 'em time. There's no telling who will be the next winner. Intercontinental Champion.
Well, this matchup here is going to be real good because you got Chico Santana. He's a former Intercontinental Champion. He's got the experience. He's got the speed. And Chico has the desire. But he's giving up tremendous size, tremendous strength advantage there, too. And plus, the slickster outside the ring.
It'd be a big factor in this matchup.
The game plan. Chico looks in great shape.
He does. The best condition of his life.
Our Portland, Maine area WWF fans, in 1 week's time, we are on our way to the Cumberland County Civic Center. That's Saturday night, May 5th. On our way with strongman Dino Bravo. On our way with Brutus the Barber Beefcake. And not to forget the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase. They will be in action as well as others in 1 week's time on Saturday, May 5th at the Cumberland County Civic Center in Portland, Maine.
The Akeem already cutting the ring off on Chico. And that's what Chico's got to do. He's got to hit and run. He's got to move.
Look at Akeem. That's a little different style. And again, Akeem makes his line. Santana easily escaping.
And that's what Chico needs to do. Frustrating.
Frustrating?
Frustrate him. Meaning Akeem. Now he's caught.
Right hand misses. Akeem taking too much time there. Santana pouring it on.
And Chico using that speed. I said it at the outset. That's what he's got to do.
And Akeem to the outside. You can bet he'll be back with different strategy.
You think Chico thumbed him there? Akeem holding that eye.
Yeah.
Chico may have got the thumb in there. You know, Chico knows all the tricks of the trade.
And Santana being warned by the official now. Well, it looks best. But again, I think it was you, Jesse, who said you could pretty much pull out all the stops in any sort of championship matchup, but in effect is what you have here.
Yeah, absolutely. If you lose here, you're out of the tournament. It's win or else. There's no tomorrow. Double elimination.
Is Santana going to fall for this?
Well, you think as long as Chico's been around,
about that? He fell for it, all right. But Akeem wasn't looking.
Whoa, my! And that one, Akeem had to go or lose the arm.
Into the arm bar here.
And this is smart wrestling by Chico Santana. Get the big man off his feet. Get him down on the mat. Get an extremity like an arm or a leg and start working it over. Very smart. And you know, the longer this match goes, the more it shifts to Chico's advantage, I think. Chico's going to have better stamina.
Would you please stop it? It's Tito, not Chico.
It is not Tito, it's Chico. I've told you time and again, I've known this guy, McMahon, years and years ago in Tijuana, Mexico. Years ago. Long before he or I were even in wrestling.
Really?
Yes.
Akeem now, hammering to the back of the neck. Akeem with Santana, whips him to the buckle. And here comes Akeem, who misses.
And Chico using that speed well.
Santana has really been pouring it on here.
He's
using
a fist.
Standing drop kick, and the big man won't go down. And another one. This one takes him down.
Second time's the charm.
Santana shoves to the buckle. Nice maneuver on the part of Akeem.
And there's a big mistake by Chico. He got stung now. And this is the point he had to watch out for in this matchup, getting hurt.
Off the road. The ball on the part of Akeem. Akeem to the outside.
And Akeem's going to have trouble beating a 10 count here.
What up, Dave? Here comes Akeem. He's coming down.
Classify this somewhat of an upset, McMahon.
folks here in the surrounding areas around Boston, as well as right in the city, who just can't get enough, make your way to Worcester Friday night, May 18th, to catch all the live action taking place at the Worcester Centrum. Brutus the Barber Beefcake will be at the Worcester Centrum to take on the genius, the superfly Jimmy Snuka. He faces the Barbarian, the Bushwhackers, in tag team competition. They'll tangle with Rhythm and Blues. One-on-one at Sapphire, meeting up with Sensational Queen Sherry and the Macho King Randy Savage in the main event. Battles Dusty Rhodes. Right now, let's get back to tag team competition. The Bushwhackers talking about the musical duo Rhythm and Blues.
Whoa! Yeah! Oh, you know, Cousin Luke.
What's that, Cousin Luke?
Well, I think those Rhythm and Blues, I think they bit off more than I can chew.
That's right,
they went just with those bloody guitars. You know, Cousin Luke. Oh, yeah. When it comes to chewing, nobody chews better than the Bushwhackers. And before we chew, we're going to do a lot of tenderizing.
That's
and
right,
a lot of pulverizing.
A lot of
so Rhythm and Blues, when we get you in the ring, you're bloody history.
Yay.
Well, it's the Bushwhackers, Luke and Butch, who plan to make Rhythm and Blues their next smash hits, May 18th. The Macho King Randy Savage and Sensational Queen Sherry, two separate matches. They meet Dusty Rhodes and Sapphire.
Whoa, 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 you talk about the Macho King Randy Savage. You talk about Sensational Sherry, the Queen. One respect, one royalty. We talking about embarrassment, baby. We talking about you, Sherry, putting your hands on Sweet Sapphire. We talking about the ungalled attack of the Macho King Randy Savage on Dusty Rhodes from the backside. And down in Texas, we talk about that kind of royalty as Yellow Dog. And throughout the country, as the roar goes up when you walk to the arena now, you will become Yellow Dolls. Come here, baby.
Sherry, not only am I going to put dots on you, I'm going to black both of your eyes, and you know I can do it.
Dusty Rhodes and Sapphire are set for two royal encounters Friday night, May 18th at the Worcester Centrum.
Just goes to show you, McMahon, what desire and determination can do.
Indeed.
Ah, here we go.
Yeah, here we go. All right.
Yeah. And we are looking at, you know,
what?
In retrospect a little bit, I had some arrogance at WrestleMania, you know. I just opened the lid on it. You should have seen Rhona Barrett chasing me around in the booth.
Really?
Yes. I mean, she went nuts.
Because of arrogance?
Yes, that's what happens when you use this stuff, McMahon.
Yeah, you were supposed to get me a little bit. What happened?
I haven't seen no money yet.
Yeah, but it's so far.
You think I'm going to do you a favor?
I guess I shouldn't expect anything as ridiculous as that.
Rick the Mono Martel himself. Oh, look, you don't turn your back on Martel. And Paul Roma did just that, and Martel is off and running.
Just how far will the Mono run, however? I mean, will he make it all the way to the top rung of the ladder in the Intercontinental Championship Tournament? I don't know. Dino Bravo took a step in that direction earlier this week. And, of course, Tito Santana, he's already won his first round matchup over Akeem. So the model, I'm sure, is looking for a victory here, Jesse.
Oh, my! Well, he's not going to get it that way. Paul Roma moving out of the way, and Martel clotheslined the iron post.
Paul Roma certainly will give the model a tremendous run for his money here. Roma was on because he wasn't selected to be in the tournament.
You know, what would happen if Roma scored an upset here on the model Rick Martel as far as the Intercontinental Tournament goes?
What would happen?
Yeah.
Arrogance wouldn't smell so good. That's what would happen.
My arrogance always smells good, McMahon.
Really?
I mean, I've been
across the arc.
Since I've been using it out in L.A.,
yeah.
Oh, I've been having the time of my life.
Really?
I mean, I'm exhausted most of the time, McMahon.
Like a dog still chasing you down the sidewalk?
Yeah. Dogs?
Well, You know, I'm told that one of the downsides of putting aggregates on, though, is it really does attract a lot of insects. Is that true?
Insects?
Yeah, mosquitoes, Robert, you know, and lightning bugs, you know. Ladybugs.
Blonde ladybugs. Brunette ladybugs. Redhead ladybugs.
If it's as good as you say, Jesse.
It's better than I say.
Really?
Yes. That's why you'll never get your hands on any of it.
Well, I haven't seen any of the stores. Ooh, the model missing with the left elbow there. And a seesaw matchup here with Roma and Martel.
Another reminder, in 1 week's time, Saturday night, May 5th, 8 p.m. starting time, the WWF at the Cumberland County Civic Center in Portland, Maine. Tito Santana will see action. You'll see the Birdman, Coco Beware. Also, the genius, Rhythm and Blues, the Big Boss Man. It's a who's who coming to Portland, Maine. WWF wrestling at its finest on Saturday night, May 5th, at the Cumberland County Civic Center.
Hooking the top rope.
Trying to get him over now for the Boston Crab.
He's got it.
And he's got it. So
I don't think there's any way out. I don't think
it's over. It's over.
Yep. Big win for the model.
A top win for the model, Rick Martel. And Roma almost pulling off an upset.
The model, Martel.
Oh, boy. And now all of a sudden it's time to be...
Yeah, look who's holding the sign. Ha!
Ha! Who was holding the sign?
You didn't catch that?
No, I didn't.
Sweat hog.
I beg your pardon. I think you owe that young lady an apology.
Ha! I owe no one an apology. Great leapfrog there by the model Rick Martel. But Roma catches him with a dropkick. Reversal right there. Martel off the rope, leapfrog. Roma going for the drop kick, the big mistake, the back of his head crashing on that mat. Martel cinching in the Boston Crab and finish it off with a little bit of arrogance.
Yeah, and Otto may be on his way to Los Angeles for next year's WrestleMania.
The Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum, site of Super Bowls, the World Series, the Olympics, and now the site of WrestleMania 7. The event that will shatter all past Coliseum attendance records on March 24, 1991. Join the more than 100,000 fans who will be part of the biggest WrestleMania extravaganza of all time. For tickets, call Ticketmaster at 1-800-877-1414. In California, call 213-480-3232. WrestleMania 7, order your tickets now. California, here we come.
I can't wait for this one, Jesse.
Come on!
make your plans if you live in or around Worcester, Massachusetts. Friday night, May 18th at the Worcester Centrum. As we mentioned earlier, Rhythm and Blues will take on the Bushwhackers. Also, the Macho King Randy Savage collides with the American Dream Dusty Rhodes. And then the one-on-one explosion that certainly will loom when sensational Queen Sherry opposes Sapphire. What a big night in Worcester. It's Friday night, May 18th at the Worcester Centrum.
So strong, he's huge, just immense, he's so massive.
Whoa, wow. And to go with that mass, he's very agile. He moves well,
extremely athletic. And the elbow drops. Picked up some comments a little bit earlier on from this man, the Earthquake.
I gave Hulk Hogan the Earthquake before WrestleMania 6. I caused him to lose the World Wrestling Federation Championship. I'm taking all the credit for that, and now I'm taking over the World Wrestling Federation.
Growing up in Binger, Oklahoma.
Right now, let's take you back to WrestleMania, the tag team matchup involving the Orient Express and the Rockers. Here's what happened outside the ring.
Double knocker knocker coming up. Two count. Oh! Sato hit Tanaka. That could be a turning point. Double drop kick and a beauty. He spun all the way around in midair, Jess. Came down face first. Oh, look at that. Fuji caught Jannetty on the leg. Jannetty's had just about enough of Fuji. Fuji dropped the cane. Meantime, the action continues inside the ring. And from behind, salt right in the eyes.
Well, that eliminates Jannetty. You can bet on that. He's down and out for at least five.
He's blinded here. Doesn't have a clue where he's going. Oh, he just walked right over the railing.
You can bet the Rockers are looking for one. You found something humorous there?
Yeah, the Rockers needed a little seasoning. The Orient Express gave it to them.
Seasoning.
Yeah.
And here's a
moment. This will be interesting. Take a look at the size of this man.
He is a big one.
Virginia, he is a big one. Big tugboat, yeah. Against another good size individual here in Joe Champ. Joe Champ displaying a double bicep.
Look at the size of tugboat's back.
What is that we're looking at? Oh, a sailor's back. Tugboat is just huge. Off the rope and tugboat.
Look at how it's a shoulder on it. Look at how nonchalantly he did that, too.
Grab a gauge to speak to tugboat. But before the broadcast, here's what he had to say.
Oh, sure, it's going ashore. Hey, I need to tell all those WWF wrestlers, you better bring your life preservers and your water wings and know how to tread water real well, because I'm about to make the biggest splash in WWF history.
You know, wait a minute, McMahon.
What?
I'm not...
Whoa!
Look at that. A standing drop kick for the man that size.
You've got to be impressed, Jesse.
I'm impressed, but you know the one thing I got a complaint on?
What's that?
Very simply, I don't get paid enough to listen to Hacksaw Jim Duggan hoot. Now I got to listen to this guy, too.
Whoa! Forget it! By the way, do you think he's referring to you when he referred to water wings? Maybe not, huh?
Whoa.
I can see you in the pool now with your little water wings on.
I wasn't a guy. Wait a minute.
I know all about it.
I wasn't a black shoe sailor.
A what?
A black shoe sailor. Look down in your book and figure out what it is.
Hondo! Whoa, baby! He'll be a force to reckon with here in the World Wrestling Federation as we take you now to the event center.
The action kicks off tonight at 8 p.m. at the Garden. I know Rick Cavallari and the boys from Up the Heights in East Boston are going to be there because they know Hulk Hogan has a big score to settle with the Earthquake. Standing by the Hulkster with some last-minute comments.
You know something, little Hulksters? I can't help but think, just like you dudes, about the last time we encountered the Earthquake Man. When he tried to squash Hulkamania, there were tremors everywhere, dudes. There were aftershocks. We were all affected. But with Hulkamania being reborn, man, with all the reborn Hulkamaniacs out there, the training, the prayers, and the vitamins, the strongest force in the universe is stronger than anything in the world. But when I think about getting it on one-on-one with the Quake dudes, I think about the San Andreas fault line that runs north and south up and down California, really close to Venice Beach, where I hang and bang all day, really close to the headquarters of Hulkamania. If the Earthquake gets lucky when we lock up, if something happens, he was delivered the big one, the 10 on the Hulkamania Richter scale, the Earth would open along the San Andreas fault line. The Earthquake would be devoured up. The Hulkster would be devoured up, and all you Hulkamaniacs would go down with us. But that would only give us the chance to prove to the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, and the only natural disaster in the WWF, the Quakester dudes, that we're stronger than anything they can lay on us. We would crawl out of the vault. We would rise to the top of the mountain and prove to Jack Tunney and the whole WWF, as we buried the Quake miles below, that Hulkamania will never die.
Well, after hearing those comments from Hulk Hogan, it appears it is the Earthquake who is going to need the insurance, as well as Jimmy Hart. He'll be at ringside tonight at the Boston Garden. Also, Tugboat. He'll be set for singles competition. The Mighty Hercules. He tangles with Haku. The Barbarian meets up with the Superfly, Jimmy Snuka. It's Axe and Smash of Demolition. They will defend the Tag Team Championship belts against the Hart Foundation, Bad News Brown. He battles Jake the Snake Roberts. And in the main event, we just heard from Hulk Hogan, he faces the Earthquake. Catch it all tonight, beginning at 8 p.m. at the Boston Garden. There's still time. Do not miss this night.
Later this weekend, the Ultimate Warrior defends the World Wrestling Federation Championship for the very first time on television. And the Hulkster as well sees action one-on-one against Mr. Perfect. Let's hear now from the Ultimate Warrior, followed by the Hulkster.
My warrior, with the breath that you take are filled with poisons of the aftermath of the greatest battle, the greatest war we have ever had. But now is not the time to come close in feeling human emotion. Now is the time to let that air out. Breathe that air into the victims that lie before us. You, Haku, lie before me this weekend. And in trying to capture the world title, you shall fall to the power of the warrior.
This weekend, Mr. Perfect, Hulkamania is going to run wild and ruin your perfect record. We're also going to prove, Mr. Perfect, to you, once and for all, that Hulkamania is still the strongest force in the universe.
All that happens later on this weekend, however, next week, right here on the Superstars of Wrestling,
The Intercontinental Tournament continues. Yes, indeed. It's one-on-one. The Superfly, Jimmy Snuka, versus Mr. Perfect. We asked for some comments from Mr. Perfect, who ignored his matchup with Hulk Hogan this weekend. Looking past the Hulkster, he's keying in on the Superfly.
Next week, Jimmy Superfly Snuka, the first round of the Intercontinental Tournament. You're going to find out just like everybody else has to. I am what I say I am, and I say I'm absolutely perfect.
We'll look forward to more World Wrestling Federation action this weekend, as well as next week here on the Superstars of Wrestling. The Intercontinental Championship Tournament continues. One-on-one, Superfly Jimmy Snuka versus Mr. Perfect.